We are Onyx Imaging. We are the highest rated and most reviewed printer service center in Oklahoma.
Hi, my name is John with Onyx Imaging. Today we're going to take a look at this Brother MFC L9570 printer. I'm going to show you how to replace your belt unit. So if you're getting a belt unit low or replace belt unit warning, we're going to show you how to get that taken care of. It's a very simple process. So the first thing we need to do is we need to lower this front cover. So here over on the right side, you're going to see a button. You're going to push down that button, and that's going to release this front cover so you can open it all the way down into its locked position. Once you've done that, we need to remove our drum tray. So you're going to grab this number one handle, you're going to pull this tray all the way out, and then over here on the left side, you're going to see a little green tab labeled number two. So you're going to want to find that tab, and you're going to push it over to the left, so it's at about a 45 degree angle. You'll feel it kind of click over. So now what we can do is we're going to grab the number one handle, and here in the back of the tray, there's another handle labeled number three. So you're going to grab the number one and number three handle. You're going to lift up on number one, and you'll feel the drum tray just kind of release from the printer. You're going to want to carefully set that on a clean, dry, flat surface. And now that we have that removed from the printer, when you look inside of here, you're going to see this big green piece of plastic here in the front. That's actually the handle for our belt unit. So you're going to reach in, you're going to grab that green piece of plastic, lift it up carefully, and remove it from the printer. And there you have your belt unit. So now that you've successfully removed your belt unit, you're going to want to unpackage your new one. Make sure you remove all the packaging material. And then you want to be very careful whenever you're handling your belt unit, especially when you're handling the new one that you're getting ready to install. You never want to touch anything that's along the belt here. If you get fingerprints or anything like that on it, it can cause print defects as well as shorten the life of your belt. So be very, very careful. You only want to handle it by the hard plastic on the surrounding areas, especially this green handle in the front is primarily where you want to hold it. So once you have your new one unpacked, carefully put it back inside the printer. Again, holding it by that green handle so it's all the way in the back. Lower it down. You'll feel it click down into position. Now we've successfully installed our new belt unit. So now we're going to reinstall our drum and toners. So again, holding the number three and number one handles, we're going to start back up at an angle. We're going to set this drum right back inside, and you feel it kind of click in there. And then before we can push the tray all the way back, you need to find this number two tab again and flip it back to the right so it's back in a vertical position. And now we can push our drum and toners all the way back inside the printer until they're in their locked position. We're going to raise this front cover back up until it's in its locked position as well. Now we'll give the printer a second to initialize, and what you're going to want to do is we're still going to notice that you're getting that error. So what we need to do to remove that error is we need to tell the printer that we replaced that belt unit. In order to do that, here in your control panel, on the bottom left side there's going to be an option labeled All Settings. It's going to have a little wrench and a screwdriver next to it. You're going to click on the All Settings option. Now we're going to use the on-screen arrows, and we're going to scroll down until we find Machine Info. Click on Machine Info. Again, use the on-screen arrow keys. We're going to scroll down until we find Parts Life. Click on your Parts Life. And if you go down to the second option, you're going to see where it says Belt. You're going to press and hold the Belt option. Usually it's going to take about 3 to 5 seconds. And you'll see the screen switch to a reset menu. And it's going to ask you, did you reset the belt? You're going to click Yes or No. Once you click Yes, that's going to reset your belt count. So now you've successfully replaced your belt unit, and you told the printer that you've replaced that belt unit, so it's reset your belt counter. And so now the error message will go away until it's time to replace that belt again. So we hope that helps. If you have any questions or concerns, please feel free to reach out to Onyx. We'd love to help answer those for you. Also, if there's any way we can help supply with any of your printer or office supply needs, please feel free to reach out to Onyx. We'd love to help supply those for you as well. We hope you have a great day in your backup and printing. Thank you.
Thank you for watching. If you're interested in how you can receive free labor on all of your service calls, as well as how to qualify for free printer upgrades, contact us today. We are here for all of your printer and office supply needs.